Hi, I'm Allie Daniels, and I'm coming at you live from NECAT Studios. Today, my friend, Gina, is here for just some good questions that we're going to be asking, talking about your travels that I've heard about.
Sure, absolutely.
So, where have you traveled to in the past year?
In the past year, I've been all over the U.S., and when I say all over, all over. In 1 week, I went from Los Angeles to Nashville, and then from Nashville to Miami. And so the U.S. travel has been probably almost as extensive as overseas, but was able to go to London, England a couple of times, Paris, France for the COP 2016, which was the whole negotiation for climate change that everyone in the world but the U.S. decided to really participate in, although we decided to participate in it under President Obama, but since then we've pulled out of COP.
I wonder why.
And then I went to Zambia, South Africa, just in September. Just got back from Zambia.
Zambia. What did Zambia look like? Like I've heard South Africa is beautiful, but like Zambia, I've actually never heard of.
Of Zambia?
Zambia.
Zambia is almost in the middle of the country, so down in the lower end, and it's almost flat in the middle. So it's has all the same charismatic wildlife that you think of when you think of Kenya or Tanzania. But they're not as free roaming as they are in those places because Zambia is a much smaller country. Incredibly dry. I mean, when we got off the plane, we could hear there was another flight landing that had some very ceremonial guest on it. So there was a lot of drumming and singing in the parking lot. So when we got off the plane, it was like, wow, I'm in Africa. And it looks exactly like it looks on TV. It's dry. The little tiny trees don't get very big because it's so dry. Kids are walking with water on their heads. Women are walking. They're carrying everything. Not tons of cars, at least out away from the city. So we landed in Lukasa, which is the capital of Zambia. But that's where Victoria Falls is.
Okay.
So the world's largest falls is in Zambia, but it's in the far corner of Zambia.
And what sort of animals did you get to see while you were there?
We saw elephants. We saw a bunch of crazy birds, and I can't tell you all the names of all the crazy birds. And then a lot of weird stuff that would crawl in our rooms at night. So I never knew when I woke up in the morning what would be on the wall. Some kind of lizard, some kind of gecko.
Wow. Well, it was so much fun talking to you today, but we've run out of time. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.
All right. Welcome, everyone, to Lonnie Lou's Love Show, Life, Love, and All of the Above. Today, my guest is Allie. Oh, Allie, tell us something good, will you please? Wait, first, cut your deck.
Okay.
Oh, my goodness. Okay, tell us the news. I hear that you have a date tonight.
Why, yes, Lana, I do.
Yeah?
The special guy, his name's Luke. We met just a few weeks ago.
Okay.
And he asked me out to a movie.
He asked you out, how sweet. In these modern times, you know, like it can go either way.
Right.
You know? It's really kind of hip and groovy. So his name is Luke, that's a strong name. And how did you all meet?
We met through a film camp that we did. And we both share a passion in film and a few other things, and I'm really excited about tonight.
Do you know what you're doing?
We're gonna go see Beauty and the Beast.
How romantic.
Yes, he suggested it.
Oh boy, this guy seems like a real catch. I like him already. And same age?
Maybe a year older, but.
Cool, that's cool. And is this like a serious thing?
No, not at the moment. Okay. I don't really see it going anywhere, but I'm open to the possibility of maybe a second date. But
yeah, a fun person to go hang out with and have a have a movie with. Well, the Jack of Clubs is telling me very good things about this date coming up. I see popcorn in your future, and you know, maybe a Coke if you're into that kind of stuff. And I don't know if you want to be a little adventurous. This kind of puts a little spice in my movie life, but you should try jalapenos on your popcorn.
Jalapenos.
It's delicious. It kind of just takes it to a whole new world. So I have another question, though. Mm-hmm. I hear you're also really, you're a musician as well. You play mm-hmm. some music, and you have a YouTube channel. Mm-hmm. Can you tell me a little bit, like, about that?
Well, my YouTube channel started a while back. I was maybe in the seventh grade and started out with just gaming.
Yeah.
But now it's progressed to short movie skits and original songs.
My goodness.
That I've recorded.
That's so great.
Yeah.
You're totally talented and
Thank
lovely.
You.
So maybe you and Luke will have some like creative kinship together, mm-hmm. which can
yeah,
be pretty
definitely.
Cool.
Definitely.
Well, I just hope that you have the best time tonight. I think you're gonna just maybe even, if he's lucky enough, he might even get like a little smooch on the kitchen. Maybe. I don't know. Just thinking out loud.
Maybe.
Well, Allie, thank you so much for coming here tonight. It's been a treat.
Thank you for
everyone.
Me.
Go find a love and hug him.
Hi, I'm Trish Christ. Welcome to the Memphis Music Show. Today I have my new friend Lana Deering from Sun Studio.
Hey.
Welcome, Lana.
Thank you. Thanks so much for having me on today.
I am delighted to have you here today,
hey.
And I can't wait to talk to you about one of my favorite things in the world, music.
Mine too. Good. Got that in common.
So, yes, many things I think we have in
yeah.
common. I know music touches many aspects of your life. Let's first talk about personal music in your world.
Absolutely.
You make stuff, right?
Try to. Okay. Like it's pretty much the way that sometimes my music is created is through real life stories and, you know, moments in time that I'm actually really going through, and emotions and highs and lows and in-betweens.
We
and
all have those.
Yeah, so that's kind of, it makes me not feel so alone, you know, because I really feel like there's other people out there that have obviously all gone through everything.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Nice to kind of share and get them out there and in different ways, you know, hopefully.
I don't know if you've ever heard of Eddie Stubbs, but he is a like 50-year DJ on WSM radio.
Well, I don't know.
Fantastic voice, wonderful, wonderful radio guy. And he says when he is 3 a.m. and it's his time slot and he's talking about this next song is by Johnny Cash, written in 1967 or what
yeah.
have you, he doesn't imagine the 30,000 people who are listening to him. He imagines one person, one Lana Deering, sitting at home.
That's
having a conversation with him, and that's what you just said about sharing an emotion with a music recipient.
Yeah.
That made me think of.
That's sweet. Well, that gave me the chills. I mean, that's really, you know, touching.
It's a really vulnerable way to share yourself with the world.
It is.
So, what kind of music do you make?
Well, we like to call it sexy music. Which is, you know, I don't know, see, maybe I'm going too far out on a limb there, but just kind of moody and maybe not quite right and soft and harsh and edges and smoothness and, you know, all those kind of just dynamics is probably where.
Just like life.
Yeah.
Yeah. I always say Yay. If the shortest distance between two points is a straight line, I don't want my life to be the shortest distance between two points. I want every up, and I will take every down to make it the longest ride possible.
Amen. Yeah. And, like, detour.
Exactly.
Maybe wrap around.
Get lost a few times. Rewind. Come back.
Yeah. I'm going to take that. I'm going to use your map.
Good.
It's my new musical map.
Well, I'm delighted that the map brought you here to Nashville, Tennessee
Thank
today
you.
For the Memphis Music Show, hosted by Trish Chris, today featuring Lana Deering.
Hey.
And I want to invite you to come back again in the future, and you, dear viewers, to watch again next time. We'll find out who it is.
Yay.
Thanks.
Hello. You are watching The Gardening Channel, and I'm your host, Uncle Jim of Uncle Jim's Combination Plant Monastery and Gregorian Nursery. Today we have Trish Christ with us discussing many different plant matters. First question to start us off, what is your least favorite kind of tree?
I love all kinds of trees. Oh, least favorite? Well, I do hate the hackberry.
And why is that?
Glad you asked, Finn. I park under a hackberry every day at my home. In the summer it's beautiful and leafy and green, but the other 3 months of the year it rains down pellets in the winter, or mushy poo in the springtime, or black smudge in the fall.
Now, how large would you say these pellets are? Are they bigger than a bread box, or?
They, what? Let me think about that. No, they are not bigger than a bread box.
I'd hope so.
More English pea. Skittle. skittle, if you will.
I see. Now, I would say that my least favorite kind of tree is a Bradford pear because they smell terrible.
Bleh.
They are terrible.
Bleh.
And they break very easily.
I agree.
But on the flip side, however, what is your favorite kind of tree?
Easy. The mimosa. Do you have a mimosa in your world?
Do you care to explain?
Well, yes, you can climb a mimosa no matter how out of shape you are because the trunk starts kind of at like shin level.
Oh, I see.
It's like a good...
That begs the question, though, which came first, the drink or the tree?
Wow. I'm going to go tree because someone was either climbing a mimosa or sitting under a beautiful mimosa, thirsty.
Or, consider this, they drank the drink before they climbed the tree, and then they climbed the tree and then fell and just shouted the first thing on their mind, which was mimosa.
Like CWI, climbing while intoxicated.
Yes.
Yes.
It happens.
Yes.
Well, I would say that my favorite kind of tree, though it's more a show about you, that as Uncle Jim, I love all kinds of trees, but I'd say my favorite is the tulip poplar, mostly because they were found in my childhood home. Except I
do. Inside your home you had tulip poplars?
Inside of them, yes.
My, your parents
my
were
mother
kooky.
Was very prolific about her plant growth. Because that has a double meaning. Anyway, the one bad thing about tulip poplars, though, is that they drop these little spiny mm-hmm. kind of seeds in mm-hmm. spring, which can get into your foot and have many, many times.
The Lego of nature, if you will.
Yes, they that's the colloquial term for it, the Lego of nature. Mm-hmm. But I just thought of my mother. She died underneath a tulip poplar, but I'm afraid we cannot get into that today.
I just texted your mom, she's fine.
It's a Christmas miracle, everybody. Thank you for watching the Garden Channel, and we will get back to you next week on all matters containing succulents.
Oh, hi. I didn't see you there. Welcome to Cryptid Dating. I'm joined today by Finn Weber, local Flatwoods monster dater. Now, Finn, is that true? Yeah, you said, is it true that you are dating the Flatwoods
yes,
monster?
Yes, we've been in a very happy relationship for upwards of 200 years, I'd say. She doesn't age too quickly, so that's fairly convenient. But what about you? Which cryptid have you been dating?
I've been married to Mothman for 20 years.
Amazing.
How did you and the Flatwoods monster meet?
Well, I was recently stalking around the local bog, trying to find, I don't know, dead perch, animal bones.
We've all been there.
As one does. And she just came to me in a rush of light. Literally, she rushed me. She appeared out of nowhere. And in order to appease the dark spirits that live within her, I decided to take up a relationship with her because, I mean, that was the natural instinct.
And thus inviting a dark passenger into yourself.
Correct.
So, what a touching story.
I know.
So, what is day-to-day life like with the Flatwoods monster as your girlfriend?
It's very pleasant. You know, I wake up, I get some coffee, she's in the middle of the kitchen screaming triple dooms and summoning up spirits from hell, but, you know. As one does. Yeah,
in your relationship, you deal with that.
I know. But it's comforting, you know? Some people wake up to the sound of a rooster crowing or birds singing, but I wake up to the sound of the Flatwoods monster in my kitchen, floating like the eye of an undead god, so...
Yeah, just sort of screaming ancient languages that we could never comprehend.
Exactly.
Well, it says right here in my book of cryptid dating that the Flatwoods monster loves you.
Really?
And that she wants to propose.
When? Does the book say when?
Oh, it says, well, that's just a little deer.
Oh, okay.
I think that might be a Wendigo.
Oh, I see. That's another one of your favorite cryptids?
Oh, it's very good. An X, actually.
Oh, no.
No, it ended nicely. Well, oh, I found it. It says she's going to propose tonight. Tonight.
I have to go.
You have to go?
I guess you can get in one more question. Probably.
Yeah. No, I can't.
Well,
my producer's telling me that actually we're being shut down by the government.
Wait, what?
Right now? So you can catch us, both of us, on the run from the entire government.
We gotta go.
Like right now. Bye.
Hello, I'm your guest, Stella. I'm your host, Stella, and here is our guest, Jay.
Hello, I understand you've brought me here to speak about animals.
Yes, I will be asking Jay what his favorite animals are. So, what is your favorite land animal?
Well, in the flesh plane, I'm a fan of deer and lynx. And on the cyberverse, I've seen pictures of polar bears that are pretty cool.
What is your favorite sea animal?
That would have to go to any type of shark.
How about favorite bird? Or something that can fly?
That is a loaded question because there's lots of kinds of birds that are very fun and very nice. Most insects that fly are not very nice, though. I like bees. Unfortunately, they're starting to go extinct, which is an issue that we should all address as a nation and a world.
I agree. I think my favorite land animal is probably a fox. I think my favorite sea animal is a dolphin. And if it could fly, probably an owl.
Owls are a complex creature, very smart, and a little gross sometimes.
Do you have any pets?
I do. I have my dog, Millie, and she's the love of my life.
I have 8 animals. I have 3 chickens, 4 dogs, and 1 cat.
That sounds fantastic.
It's great.
That is really a lot to cuddle and pet.
If you could have an animal, if it was mythological or not, what would it be?
Well, if it was mythological, I would definitely want perhaps a dragon, because I think that commands a lot of power, and it's a good conversation piece.
I think if mine was mythological, it would probably have to be a unicorn.
Those are very solid. They grant wishes, which is a plus in any animal, I'd say.
Mm-hmm. How about a non-mythological animal?
This is a little basic, but I think I'd just like a cat. But my dog's a little wild, so...
I think I might like a sugar glider.
Those are precious.
I was this close. Only $400.
Those are more dollars than I've ever held in my entire life.
Mm-hmm. Ditto. So, have you enjoyed talking about animals?
I do. Animals are very fun.
Yes, they are. Thank you for joining us. And yeah.
Welcome to Cryptid Kids Hunters. Today's guest is Stella, and she is a world-renowned Loch Ness Monster Hunter. Hello, Stella. I understand that you've had several close encounters with Nessie. Were you ever afraid that you would die?
Well, no, actually. Well, of course, the first time when I got in the water, I was terrified to death. But, you know, as I went closer to Nessie, she didn't really seem to mind. You know, she's just very shy, and you know, now we're like this.
Why is Nessie so shy? Is she something for us to fear?
Well, she just kind of lives alone in the waters, and she doesn't really have much to do. She's just shy because she's never really had anybody to hang with.
The first time you met her, though, was it frightening? Did she raise up next to your boat? Did you meet her under the water? How did you guys first meet?
Well, I saw her come out of the water and go back under, and I was really intrigued. I was about 6, so of course I went into the water thinking that it was some kind of toy, and it turned out that it was Nessie.
Now, are there more than one monster in the Loch Ness, or is Nessie all by herself?
There's a lot of them, just she likes to stay up by the surface because she's a loner.
Are there other lake monsters around the world, or is Scotland the only place that we can find a lake monster?
Well, Scotland is the only place that you can find Nessie and her troop, because down under the water, there's like kind of like the Little Mermaid, there's a whole city where they live, and there's a lot of them. There's little ones and big ones, and I took a class of how to speak Nessie, and yeah.
Now, would you say that several people are of the opinion that Loch Ness monsters are throwbacks from the dinosaur era? Are these dinosaurs that have been trapped over time in Loch Ness,
Or do they, or is it something else? Are they another kind of animal that's just never been discovered?
Well, Nessie told me that her great, 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 great grandfather, he happened to know a few dinosaurs before they got extinct.
Oh, so she's separate from, her whole family's different from dinosaurs.
Yeah. Well, they're kind of in the same dinosaur era, kind of same genes.
Do you think other people will be able to be friends with Nessie in the future?
Well, it really just depends. If you're scared of Nessie, she usually gets scared and probably starts swimming around and might scare people, but for the most part, she's pretty friendly. If people just gave her a chance, they might, yeah.
Do you have any other monsters that you'll be hunting in the future? Or are you going to stay focused on Loch Ness?
So far, I'm not really hunting her. We're just friends.
Okay. Well, I want to thank you for being with us today and sharing with us the special things about Loch Ness monsters. And thank you all for joining us.
Hi, and welcome to We Love Pets. And we're here to talk about all the pets that we've had in our lives and current pets. Today with me is Cynthia, and thanks for being here.
Hi, I'm excited.
Yeah,
I love pets.
Yeah. Do you have any current pets?
I do. I have a dog named Lily, aww, and she is she's about 60 pounds. She's a lab mix. Yeah, she's huge, but the most loving and sweet dog that there
is. Is she a cuddler?
Yeah, she loves to cuddle and loves to lick. It's just like how she shows love. She just wants to lick you all over. So yeah. Cute and annoying at the same time, but yeah, she's super sweet. So
nice. Did you have pets growing up?
I did. We always had a ton of dogs growing up, and then we all kind of have a lot of siblings, so we went through phases of having hamsters and, you know, little things like that. But always had dogs growing up. So
yeah. So what is the craziest pet name that you have ever?
Yeah. We had a dog. It was a very tiny white Chihuahua, and his name was Poochie, like P-O-O-C-H-I-E. I don't know how to spell it. Yeah, maybe something like that, like Poochie, yeah.
Yeah.
And I think, like, as a kid, one of us just said that one day, and that, like, became the dog's name. But, yeah, it's a very silly name.
Nice. So if you could have any pet in the world, what kind of pet would you have?
Oh, a giraffe.
Oh, that's fun.
Yes. Those are my favorite animals in the whole world.
Yeah, really fun. When I was little, we had my aunt moved in across the street, and they had a pool, and I was like, yes, I can finally have a dolphin.
Oh, nice.
Keep the dolphin. And my mom would not let me, of course.
Of course, yeah.
And I didn't talk to her for like a week because I thought that she was ruining my life because she wouldn't let me keep a dolphin in the pool.
In the pool, yeah. That's the perfect place, right?
I mean, I thought it was reasonable as an 8-year-old.
Oh, man.
Excellent. So does your dog get along with other animals?
She is a little in and out. So sometimes she has dogs that she loves, and then other times she doesn't. She likes to be alpha, so if another dog is going to challenge that, she doesn't tend to like them. But if they are okay not being alpha, then she's usually okay with it.
Yeah.
So.
Excellent. I have a dog and a cat, and they do not get along. Like, the cat tries a lot to play with the dog, and then it's not interested.
Out.
So I have, like, two separate pets that do
That's
not funny. Interact.
Usually it's like the cat that doesn't want anything to do with the dog.
Yeah.
So
I think she gets jealous, and so she's like, somebody love on me.
Oh.
I don't know.
Oh,
excellent.
Man.
So are y'all going to get more pets, do you think?
Probably not.
Just one dog?
Yeah, it's a lot to handle with one dog.
And that's a big dog.
And it's a huge dog, yeah.
Yeah.
So I don't think we'll ever get any more. We used to have, like, fish and stuff, but we don't have those anymore. So.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I had a fish and I killed it. I can't keep fish together. No. But well, thank you so much for watching, and join us next week where we talk about more pets.
Welcome to NECAT. Today we know that you can't always get in the car and drive where you want to go because that can take a long time, especially with Nashville traffic. So for anyone here in the studio audience who would like to tour Sun Studio in Memphis, good news. We've brought the host of Sun Studio here. She's going to give you a tour right here in Nashville. Come on out, Lana.
Hi.
Welcome, Lana.
Thank you for having me.
Delighted to have you here. So, first question, yes, sir. What is the first thing someone would hear from you at Sun Studio?
Well, first you'd be greeted by this smile. And then we'd sell you a ticket, and we'd give you the best tour of your life of rock and roll, best tour on the market out there right now.
Does someone actually see Elvis or Jerry Lee?
Well, you'll see beautiful photos of them, and you'll actually be able to stand in the studio where all the magic happened, where they cut songs like Great Balls of Fire, where Elvis sang That's All Right, Mama.
Wow.
You can touch the microphone that Elvis sang through. It's you'll probably leave there with a few goosebumps, I'm just saying.
Neat.
Yeah.
Ma'am, yes. Oh, you know, I don't know that answer. What year did Sun Studio open?
Oh, well, Sam started in the 50s. It wasn't called Sun Studio then. It was called Memphis Recording Service. And then around 52, that's when he opened the doors of Sun Studio. Sun Records, I should say.
Wow.
Yeah.
Follow-up. Did it close, or is it still open for recording?
So the label sold to actually Shelby Singleton here in Nashville,
huh,
for $1 million back in the day.
Wow.
And around the 60s. And then the studio itself is still in existence. We're still recording to this day. So it's what really makes my heart feel good about the whole situation at Sun is that we're still doing the same thing we did when we opened our doors back when Sam started it.
I love it.
Yeah.
Are you a musician, sir? Of course you are. This is Nashville.
Yeah. Throw the stick and hit a few musicians, I'm sure.
Okay, I think we have time for one more question.
Oh, great.
Let's take it from this lovely lady here.
Hi.
Oh, I don't know. Okay. Lana, were there women involved on the management side?
Oh, yeah. Marion Keisker, she was the woman who, like, found Elvis. She was the one. Miss Marion Keisker. She said Elvis was a good ballad singer, and the rest is history.
She was not wrong.
No. Good man.
You guys, thank you so much for taking this drive to Memphis with us here over on White Bridge Road today. We'll do it again next time, and maybe we'll go to, what do you think, Austin?
Austin.
Join us next time in Austin, Texas.
All right, welcome to the exercise show. Put your hands together. All right, woo! Welcome to the show. I'm so happy that my guest here today, Stella's joining me with me. We're gonna have a bombin' good workout. We're gonna start working on just kind of getting our bodies woken up with an amazing stretch. How's that sound, Stella? Okay, so this one, I'm just gonna demonstrate a little bit. We're just gonna reach our hands over our head and up to the sky. Oh, and then we're gonna bring them back down. Everyone at home, you're gonna try with us. Here we go, ready? And reach to the sky. I'm not a bad guy, I'm a good guy. And bring him back down. Woo, how you feeling?
Spicy.
Nice. I like a little spice in my life. Well, we're gonna work on another stretch right now. This one I kinda like, it starts with your foot up. You can do your left or right foot, whatever feels good. And now we're just gonna kind of slowly lean forward. Touch your toes. Oh yeah, kinda like we're ballerinas. And then we're gonna bring them back up and like look up with our eyes. It's always good to look with your eyes where you're going, then back down one more time. Okay, great. Now we're gonna rotate, bring up the other foot here. Okay, and do the same thing. Don't you feel like the swan princess in that ballerina show? Okay, and up. Okay, cool. Great. Okay, now we're gonna bring them back down. Maybe just kind of roll your neck a little bit side to side. Yeah. Okay. How you feeling?
Good.
A little loosened
spicy
up?
Spicy.
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 Okay. I was thinking maybe we could do this one move. It's really good for your legs, and it's kind of like a squat. Does that sound good?
Yeah.
Okay. So you want to kind of bring your feet a little bit out, like hip length there, hip width apart, whip. And now you're just going to kind of push your buttocks out to the back skyline. And there you go. And bend at the knees. Perfect. Now back up. There you go. We're going to do one more of those. Oh, yeah. And back up. Now let's reach for the sky again. All right. Yeah, one with the sky. This is another move that I like to do. It's kind of a face yoga move. I don't know. Maybe you guys want to get up close on this one. But this helps bringing life back into your face if maybe feeling a little dull. So you go like this. You go. Cover your teeth with your mouth. Yeah. Yeah. And then you're going to do an O and a smile. And say goodbye as we're doing it. Oh my. Thank you so much for joining our show. Okay, I'm going to see you next week on the exercise show. Can't wait to have you all back. Stay fit, stay healthy, and just remember, good times are to come all the time if you just stay happy. And you can be down a little bit.
Hi, welcome to Real Talk. I'm Trish Christ, and I'm here with my real friend to Real Talk with Real Gina Hancock. I've known you for quite some time now, and yes. We've worked together, we've played together, we've laughed, we've cried, all of that. And so we're going to have some real talk.
Okay.
I want to say that I admire you so much.
Oh, I admire you too.
I do. I admire your work. I admire the way you live your life. And I want to talk about what we're going to do at the end of our days. I know that's a deep topic, but it's something that you also work in. And not a lot of people know about an organization that you work with.
Mm-hmm.
So if you would, start by telling us about the concept called green burial. What is that?
So green burial is where the body is not embalmed and you're not placed in a casket. You can be wrapped. Your body can be anointed or preserved with essential oils. Or you can be put in a basket, a woven basket.
Wow.
So that is all a more natural way to be after you've gone on.
Is the wrapping like how the Egyptians would wrap a mummy, that kind
of
thing?
Not like that, but there are some linens that are being manufactured and produced, and in Nashville Thistle Farms is producing an essential oils to use to bathe the body and anoint the body. So
upon death, rather than going down to a store and buying a casket and planning a funeral that way, green burial is a way to reconnect with the earth.
Right. Well, and with your family, you know, especially in the South, we have a long burial tradition of the body is in the living room and people come and go from the home and the relatives sit up all night and reminisce and talk about the one that's passed. And you just stay at home. You don't go anywhere. And then when it's time to go to the cemetery, you just got trucked on out in a wood box and were put in the ground. And you probably laid at rest in your home for 18 hours or less, and it was over. And it wasn't until the Civil War that we preserved bodies with all kinds of formaldehyde and all kinds of things that now undertakers and morticians use, because we couldn't get the bodies back home. And so they wouldn't last. Mm, so right. That's when we started preserving bodies in the United States.
It's kind of amazing to me. And you and I both worked in nature and have a love for the planet.
Right.
And to think that we could just return to the planet when it's over. We don't need a casket. We don't need fluids. We don't need fancy dress.
Well, there's more concrete underground than on top of the ground because of what has become traditional burial. It's not really, to me, traditional burial, but today there's cement vaults that are poured over caskets and all kinds of things.
You're watching NECAT. You're watching NECAT. You're watching NECAT. You're watching NECAT.
You're watching NECAT. Hey, you're watching NECAT.
You're watching NECAT. You're watching NECAT.
You're watching NECAT.
Thanks for watching NECAT! Thanks for watching NECAT! Thanks for watching NECAT! It's our Nashville.
It's our Nashville.
I'm having so much trouble deciding what I want to do over break.
Well, you could come to NECAT and make a television show.
Who are you?
I'm your, advisor.
All right, well.
Or you could go to the good NECAT.
The good NECAT?
Yeah.
And does that mean that this is the bad NECAT?
No, NECAT is all good. You could make a show, for example, about world domination.
Or world peace.
I mean, they both sound pretty fun.
But mine's funner.
I do like making shows.
Come to me.
No. I'm having so much trouble deciding.
Hi, Amy. Can you send them up? Thanks. Hi, Doctor. Come on in.
Hey, Brad. How's everything going in the little superhero department?
Oh, well, I have no affiliation to the Super League.
Don't you manage some of these little caped things?
Well, I'm HR. I don't really have any loyalty. I'm sort of just a wild animal.
So, is this a performance review, Brad?
In a way.
So, I guess you're gonna tell me I'm the best evil lord anywhere. I mean,
well,
you know, don't let me put words in your mouth, but.
Oh, you're putting words in my mouth.
Toxic.
Toxic is definitely one of the words I plan to use.
Thank you.
I've gotten a number of complaints.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm. As you can...
People I don't see enough.
Oh. I think they've seen plenty of you. Well, you see, there's verbal abuse. Physical abuse.
Play to your strengths, I say.
No, eating of candy bars. Just all over the place, just leaving a real chocolatey mess for the lunch people to clean up. It's very rude.
Good color.
No, it's not.
Don't smear, I love it in the
lab. No, I don't. It's very bad to look at. There's things like slipping and falling and hurting of arms.
Now,
and then,
to your point, Brad, the slipping and the falling, I hear you.
Mm-hmm, you do. I'm so
glad. Because, you know, we use slime in the lab, right?
Yeah, that's
a lot of my havoc is slime-based, and so you may or may not recall in the past few budget proposals, I have asked for a spiked floor so that if people slip, they'll stick.
That doesn't really help our hurting issue. We'll circle back to that. It goes on and on. Things about radiation.
It's expensive, now I'll grant you that. That's why I was looking for the extra funding from, you know.
So the situation that we're dealing with here, it's sort of just.
You won't embarrass me, Brad.
Oh.
You can go ahead and say everyone's been telling you I'm awesome.
Well, those aren't the words they used.
Fearsome.
Well, the words they used were cruel, upsetting.
Go on.
Disgusting. And a nuisance.
I've been doing this for a long time, Brad.
I know. You knew my father, Brad the Bone Crusher.
I ate your father.
Yes, Brad the Bone Crusher. So what I'm thinking is to sort of resolve these issues, We're gonna need a couple classes. Anger management.
Be happy to teach it.
Oh no, no, never. So anger management, I think goodness 101 again, a good course for you, might go through that again.
To take.
We're gonna need to do some workplace sensitivity classes.
Like determining what allergies people have?
Well, that should be something that
That could be useful.
That's something we should have on file.
I agree.
Not for harming purposes. For helping. You don't want all your henchmen
Tomato.
All right, we'll get back to that. So we're also gonna need to clean up the slime.
All right, I'm gonna go get on that right now, Brad.
No. We're not done.
I'll see you later. Hey,
we're not done. Come back.
Brad says we're not done.
I did.
You know what, Brad? Is Brad's mommy there? Because we're not done.
My mother is dead.
Oh, yeah, she wasn't there. You're right. Yeah. Is this your favorite pencil, Brad?
No, it's unsharpened. Could you? I like keeping.
This could be useful.
I like keeping my desk as a sort of this is a Brad space. Oh, you're really. You knocked down my book.
That's right, Brad. I did.
Could you? Stop.
You like it tidy, Brad?
I do.
Makes you feel in charge.
And you're really.
I am. I am. Oh. Ah.
You're not gonna like this if you don't stop.
Oh really, Brad? I'm not gonna like it. What are you gonna scare me? You're gonna get all tough guy on me? Is that it? You like this book too, Brad?
It
goes in the number two book place here on the stack.
It does.
It does. 3 minutes. 2 minutes. It's this complaint. Dr. Chaotic is. Stupid. What the? Who? Oh! Ah!
All right, everybody, class is now in session. But first, let's start out with a little quiz. So, look over to this whiteboard over here. So, say you find a kitten in a tree, and it is not your kitten, and it's not your tree. How do you go about getting that kitten out of the tree?
Throwing star.
No. Try again. No. Keep going. Keep cycling. No. Here, do you want a little help?
Fire.
No. So first, you would get something like a ladder.
And bludgeon the kitty.
Also incorrect. What else can you do with a ladder?
Send a tiger up it.
No. Keep trying. You can get it.
Good is hard.
I know, but this is why you're here, basic goodness. Well, you would.
Barbed wire.
No, also bad. Let's say this is you.
Throw a child up into the tree.
Great thinking. Let's move on to something else. All right, so next hypothetical, second part of our lesson, is say you find an old woman crossing the street.
Kill her.
Also incorrect.
Kidnap her.
She has a little walker.
Cook her.
Crossing the street, and there's a car coming. What do you do?
Push her in front of the car.
Also incorrect. She's just now beginning to cross the street, though, so you still have time to stop her if you need to.
Stop her and bite her.
Good start.
Yeah, look at you.
You are just the most difficult student I've ever had, but
Thank
we will
you.
Solve this. So, you got the You got the first part right. But stop her. So,
this is. She must be stopped.
Correct. On the right path. All right. Now, now that you've solved that, you stop her before she can cross the street. Second to last, the penultimate challenge. So.
I know what that means.
Good. So do I.
That's evil people use big words all the time.
But I'm not evil, and I used a big word.
Oh, you just don't. You're pre-evil.
You see a child crying in a ditch.
Why would a child cry in a ditch?
Why wouldn't a child cry in a ditch is the better question.
He's special.
All right, let's say he's special. How will you help this special child out of the ditch?
Flush the ditch with water.
Can the child swim?
I think that's irrelevant. Trick exactly. question!
It is not a trick question. You don't know that, so you can't flood the ditch.
Throw the child
yes.
a snake.
On the right path. Let's try it again. Throw the child.
Throw the child.
You're doing so good. You are doing so good. All right, let's continue on this path of throw the child what?
Throw the child. It takes a village to throw a child.
I try. So hard.
I do too.
All right.
And I've got 7 accents already, so there you go.
Let's try this again with one last, just quick question. All right, so this is Earth. I'm sure you know it very well.
Mine!
Sure, let's do that. And out of the corner of your eye, it's a giant hot water bottle, you see an asteroid hurtling towards Earth.
Mm-hmm. Yes, yes, good, good.
No, not good. You can't rule the Earth if it's dead.
You and your intelligence.
I know.
I must stop the asteroid.
But how? You can stop an old woman, but I don't know if you can stop an asteroid.
Oh, I will take that as a challenge. I would take the old woman, ball her up, put her in a tube, point the tube at the asteroid, and shoot the old woman into space.
That's actually the right answer. You've done so good. Think of it. You're good.
I'm good.
You're good. Class is now adjourned as if it was a court.
All right, everyone. Welcome to Superfan. The superhero club right downtown Nashville. So glad you're all here. Woo! All right. Yeah. Ah, this is going to be a great night. Well, I'm just going to sing a little song to get the party started here. This song's for all you superheroes out there that, if you're feeling like our task can be pretty daunting sometime, and it's just hard, So this song's called Try, and just don't give up. Love you guys. Here you go. All right, thank you. All right, up next, Dr. Reckless.
Actually, it's Dr. Chaotic. My name. So, really happy to be here at Super Fans with all our heroic efforts. First time caller, long time listener. Okay, here's my first joke. And boy, is it, it's not funny at all. But I got another joke, and it's not funny either, and here's the punchline. She must have had to go save somebody. Good luck with that hero stuff, you. All right, here's a joke you're not gonna identify with either. Here's the punchline. Oh, you feel me on that one, right? So, So here's my third joke, or maybe fourth. I don't know what number I'm on now, but I'm going to say it to the superhero in the red cape right there. All right, for my big wrap-up and my grand finale, the... We should maybe recycle this. For my final joke of the evening, here it is. It's the worst of all. Stinker! You're laughing! I have a fan! I have a super fan! Thank you! Thank you! Do you want to do a selfie with me? All right. My first. Oh! All right, I like stand up. I'll be here all week. Litter bug. This is not trash. This is a recyclable plastic. Whoops, lost my mic. Not a trash can. This has a brand on it, so we can't use it, and it's trash.
Please don't hurt me, please don't hurt me, please don't hurt me.
I'm gonna, you gotta learn.
Don't hurt me, please don't hurt me, please. Help me! Help me!
What are you doing?
She's putting trash in the recyclables.
Let her go.
I don't want to ruin the world, I want to rule it!
Okay. Okay.
Help me? Sure. You'll see. Watch! 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 Evil is afoot. Yes!
Hi, Amy. Yeah, this is Brad from HR. Can you send Dr. Chaotic up? Thanks. Hi, doctor. Come on in.
Brad.
Hello.
I understand you want to see me.
I do. How are you today?
Evil
That's great. That's great. So glad to hear that.
It's what you pay me for.
I don't pay you. You know, that's a...
All right, Brad from HR. You do HR.
I do. Human resources and non-human resources.
Right. Right. So, Brad, I'm guessing this is about all the bad work I've been doing lately.
Well, yes. Sort of more inside the office space, though. Not really terrorizing the city. Oh, well.
You know, Brad, I know what you're going to say.
Oh.
I know. Schmidt, no need to say anything. You're going to say, Dr. Chaotic, once again, you have exceeded our evil expectations. And that's how I live my life, Brad. It's how I do my job. Over-deliver.
You have been going above and beyond.
Thank you. I know. Yes. I'm ready for my raise.
Oh, no. However, we've had quite a few complaints.
Really?
Office place disputes, I'd say.
You like what?
Things like, you've been throwing things at people.
Only sharp things, Brad.
Well, also blunt objects like beakers and cups
and... there was a beaker.
That's a bat? A living
well,
one.
Well, that bat flew over there. I had nothing to do with throwing that bat.
Okay. They said it was your bat launcher 3000.
Oh, the 3000. I might have left it on one night late.
And that gets into a whole nother department of animal cruelty.
Oh, no. Never cruel to animals.
Okay. It's not my department. I'm human resources.
Right, you're not animal resources. Yeah. Stay in your lane, Brad.
I will. I have things about verbal abuse and just sort of inappropriate jokes.
Some find my laugh toxic. Mm. I think I just have moxie.
Inappropriate jokes, one person, this sort of ties into another complaint I have. The slime. People are slipping on it and fall onto the spikes, and you make just very inappropriate jokes about...
Enjoy your trip.
instead of getting any sort of help. Just a big stack of things here. Leaving a mess, not just taking parking spaces, but destroying cars that park there.
I can't help it if flamethrowers burn, Brad. All right, look, you've clearly got a lot of work to do here,
do.
So I'm just going to go back to the lab. Take care.
No.
Brad from HR.
Doctor. Doctor. Come on back. We're not done.
I'm done, Brad.
No.
I'm a very important scientist.
I'm sure you
I've
are.
Got science to do, Brad.
I'm sure you do.
Evil doesn't do itself.
Well, we need to talk about evil for a second, so how about you just... Come
you want
take
me to
a seat.
Talk to you about evil, Brad.
Oh.
Is this Brad's mommy? Bradley would like to know about evil today.
She's not there.
You killed both of my parents.
Oh, I did. Mm. Your little Brad Bradson from Betty Bradson and Brad Bradson the First. I forgot.
So I think what we're going to do, a plan that I sort of have drawn up.
Is that plan from this book, Brad?
Please leave my books alone.
Do you love this book?
I love this
Did
book.
Did you learn a lot of evil from this book, Brad?
No. Okay, so we're going to go.
How about this book, Brad? Do you like this book, too?
This is my Brad space.
Is that an anti-social media Brad space?
I would...
All of this paperwork, Brad.
I would really like you to stop. I need to file that.
Ah, but the irony is I won't. Because, Brad, I'm in charge. I, Dr. Chaotic, am in charge. I have the power in this corporation.
He messed up my books.
Employee complaint please, please. Can't be expected to put the mayonnaise back in the refrigerator every time.
Brad, I think it's very inappropriate for you to touch me that way here. Brad!
Get out.
No idea.
All right. Hey, everybody. Welcome to a super fan, superhero comedy and music venue in downtown Nashville. I'm so glad y'all made it out tonight. Y'all look beautiful in your capes and masks. Well, I'm going to just sing a little song for y'all. This is, you know, I know our lives can be a little bit daunting being superheroes and mere mortals as well. But I just wanted to let you know that I think of this all the time and we just gotta try and be good. So here you go, the song's for you guys.
Why not try just for one day to be the person you've always wanted to be? You might be surprised. Don't take much. You might be surprised. Why don't you give it a try? Like to be on time, not to be the reason why. I like to help my friends. I like to help mankind. Yeah, why not try? Yeah, why not try to be on time, not to be the reason why. I like to help my friends, I like to help mankind. Yeah, why is it so hard? Yeah, why is it so hard to be on time? Reason why I like to help my friends, I like to help mankind. Yeah, why not try? Yeah, why not try?
Everybody, please put your hands together and give a warm welcome to Dr. Fantastic. Come on.
Yeah. Actually, it's Dr. Chaotic. Really happy to be here at Superfans. Long time listener, first time caller. Right. Why was the superhero staring at the carton of orange juice? Because it said concentrate. What's the best thing about having an evil laboratory in Switzerland? I don't know, but the flag is a big plus. Why did the hipster fall in the lake? Because he went ice skating before it was cool. What do you call it when a banana eats
another banana. Can a bananalism? Oh.
And for you, why was Cinderella kicked off the softball team? She kept running from the ball. You like that? You like me? I'm funny. My first fan selfie. Oh, I'm funny. I quite like stand-up. Thank you, Nashville. I'll be here all week.
Evil litter bug! This is trash! I know. They need help. People need help to understand how to take care of my planet. This is not trash. This is valuable, recyclable plastic. Oh, they don't get it. They don't get it. I will make them get it. I will make them get it. But no. No, no, they're stupid. They need more. Stupid, stupid, stupid. Stupid needs more help. More help. More. More help. Help, stupid. Help, stupid. Stupid is everywhere. Stupid. Stupid. My planet. Mine. Mine. What? No! No, 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 no! This is a recyclable. Not recyclable.
Someone help me.
Goes in the trash. Doesn't go there. No.
What are you doing? Let her go.
She put trash in the recycle bin.
That's no reason to hurt somebody.
For the 110 millionth time, I'm trying to rule the world, not ruin it.
I'll help you keep the earth clean.
Right. Good, superhero. Let's hide in the bushes. You'll see. You'll see. Evil is afoot.
What should I do over my break?
Work on world domination?
Well, I could do that. I don't know.
Or you can go to NECAT.
NECAT would be fun. I do like filming.
You could make a show about world domination.
Now that does sound fun.
Or you can make a show about good things.
I could do that too. Ooh, this is so hard.
Good show. Good show.
Evil.
Good show.
Evil.
Good show. Good show. Good show. Good show. Good show.
I don't know what to choose.
Good show.
Class is now in session, and I want to comment, though. This is basic goodness, and most people have already graduated into intermediate goodness or advanced goodness, but not you, Dr. Chaotic.
Well,
why is that?
I've excelled in other areas.
Okay, then. Well, let's start out with a couple hypotheticals. So, let's say you see a kitten trapped in a tree. What do you do to get that kitten down?
Throw a pointy metal thing at it.
Well, you could throw something up to it to help it get down.
Acid!
Great start. Let's try to draw something else to see if it helps at all.
Launch a rocket at the kitty!
Well, if it was a very small rocket, then the cat might be able to get into it, but let's say that's a ladder. What do you do with that ladder?
A ladder. Pick it up and hit the kitty repeatedly.
No, you would
wrap barbed wire around the ladder, lasso the kitty, and pull her back in.
Great start. Let's try again. So let's say you get to this.
Take a small child, throw him up onto the top of the ladder, and then knock the ladder out from under him, and then... Oh, no, that doesn't help the kitty.
Yeah, no, it gets both of them stuck in the... Let's just move on to something else, how about? Second hypothetical. You see an old woman about to cross the street.
Old woman.
She is. Isn't she cute?
Street.
And there's a car coming.
Push her in front of the car.
No. You're trying to keep her from getting hit by the car.
She must be stopped.
Yes,
old
good.
Old people must be stopped.
Good enough. So how are you going to stop her?
With an axe.
No.
With evil, scary words.
Well, if that stops her, I suppose it's technically the right answer. Well, that works. Next one is you see a child in a ditch, and he's crying.
Why would a child cry in a ditch?
Why wouldn't a child cry in a ditch is a better question,
You're
really.
A tricky one.
Mm-hmm. So, this child is stuck in the ditch. There are no stairs. What do you do?
No stairs. Flush the ditch with toxic water.
Well, it could help to flush it so it can swim back out, but can the child swim?
Well, I don't think that's relevant.
But it is, because if the child can't swim, the child will drown and you will fail this challenge.
And your point would be?
The child would die, Dr. Chaotic.
And?
You would fail this class.
Oh, failing again.
You're better
Fine,
than this.
Teach me what to do.
All right, so you would maybe throw something down there.
Throw something down there, like a brick.
No.
Like a snake.
All right, a long thing. Good process.
A long thing, like a spear.
Okay, maybe if the spear was blunt, you could help.
Blunt spear, what is that, like a starter spear, safety spear, child's... Oh, I see where you're going with
it. Yeah, it's a stick. You would throw a stick down to him, and he could come back out of the ditch and stop crying. Last challenge. Maybe this one will get through to you, since you know quite a lot about these, I'm sure. You see, through your magical death ray or whatever you use, an asteroid hurtling towards Earth.
Earth. Mine!
Sure. Earth. It's coming towards the Earth.
An asteroid is coming toward Earth. Good. Wow.
But it's not good, because if the Earth is destroyed, you can't rule it.
Right, it's mine. Then I must stop the asteroid.
You can stop an old woman, but you can't stop an asteroid.
Oh, I think I can.
Can you?
Yes, I can. I can. I can. I really, really can.
How?
With a pointy asteroid stopper.
Okay, how are you going to get it up there?
With a pointy asteroid stopper extension rod.
So you're going to extend it out into space? Okay. Will that stop the asteroid, though?
Yes. It's a stopper.
And once the asteroid is stopped, what then?
Party.
Well, that's actually the right answer. So you've passed. You can move on to intermediate goodness, I'd say.
I'm intermediately good.
Good is a strong word.
It is. It's not as strong as evil.
Love.